CNN's Maria Antonia is in Troy, Kansas tonight. Maria?
We are indeed by Highway 36 and Highway 7, an area that certainly saw its share of drama today and is still, you know, looking at some rather, I guess you'd call them maybe threatening clouds still hovering over this area, as you can see over here. But want you to look and listen at some of the video we captured this afternoon with the help of photojournalist Laz Ábalos. All right, what you're seeing happen between 3 and 4 this afternoon between Troy and Atchison, this is off Highway 7. Mostly what we saw most of is lightning in the area. That was the most pronounced feature of this storm that was going on as the area was under a tornado warning. Also, heavy rain. And we also noticed some pea-sized hail in that area. Again, this between 3 and 4 this afternoon in a part of the state that already saw its share of drama. I'm going to tell you about what else was going on around here, not far from the Troy area in St. Joseph. Those folks had already had much to deal with this morning, and we're going to show you the video as we tell you that about 50,000 people were left without power. There are no traffic lights, nothing for them to count on. This went on for about 50 minutes, nearly 50,000 KCPNL customers losing power. No local TV station. It was off the air. No cable, no internet, no AC. People were turning to the local radio stations that had backup power and kept broadcasting. Stations like Q Country got nonstop calls. Listen to what they had to say.
Putting a lot of, you know, stoplights, that's the big deal. Everybody driving around, stoplights are just black. And, I even saw an accident up there earlier, too, people not obeying the old, you know, four-way stop rule that goes into effect. And, I got a lot of calls about when it was going to be back on.
And they were without power for about 90 minutes, starting around 10 this morning, when the temperature around this area was already up to 88 degrees. Now, we did talk to the folks at KCPNL, and they had crews working in this area doing what is considered routine maintenance when they tell us that a low line, a sagging transmission line, probably came in contact with a tree, and that started the entire problem in this area that left all of those people without power for about 90 minutes. But power was restored in stages, and we are told that everyone was back on. But then, of course, and they faced the threatening weather this afternoon, so it has been a day full of, nonstop action for the folks in this area. Again, we're in Troy. Back to you.